In this video, we'll explore how to use a bleeding edge text-to-image model via Google Cloud's Imagen 3 API, focusing specifically on how to use it through programming rather than through a browser. We'll start by looking at the vision page within Google's Vertex AI Studio, which is where users can create images manually. While we can see some impressive image results on this page, our goal today is to learn how to generate these same kinds of images using the API directly. This approach is very flexible. You can run these API calls from many different places, including your own application code, your local computer, or even within a Jupyter notebook. To begin working with the image generation feature, we need to use the REST API. The process involves two main components. First, we need to prepare a request body that contains our specifications, and second, we need to make a curl call that includes important information, such as our location and project ID. After preparing our curl call with all the necessary parameters, we'll run it in our terminal. When we receive the response, we'll notice that it comes in Base64 encoded format. This means we'll need to decode this data to actually see and save our images. To process the response, we'll use a JSON query parser, JQ, to extract the predictions from the data. Specifically, we'll focus on getting the first prediction and then decode it into an actual image. When we run this process, we can see it working successfully. To make the results visible and accessible, we'll save the generated images to a storage bucket. We'll actually do this for both of the images we create using this method so we can compare them. After saving the images, we can refresh the page to view our results. The first image appears, and it's particularly impressive because of how photorealistic it looks. Then we can see our second image as well, demonstrating that the process works consistently. This API-based approach gives us more flexibility and automation possibilities compared to using the manual interface. It allows us to integrate image generation directly into our applications and workflows, making it more powerful for real-world applications. If you'd like to support the channel, consider starting a free trial of our new design tool, which is linked in the description, and let us know what you think. We'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions. Thank you very much for watching to the end, and please enjoy responsibly.